Hey guys, Stealth here, back with part 17 of the Second Korean War. We still have some battles going on. We have a battle scheduled for Taechon in the north, and we have one in Kangdao in the west. Now, in Kangdao I have an invasion going on, but the invasion is not as easy as I had hoped. I have only managed to capture Charlie, so I do not have any land reinforcement zones. Which means that I gotta be very defensive on this side. Try and take out as many of these vehicles carrying infantry, which there are a lot of, as I can, and support these things from the coast using either, this side, my Lafayettes or my Donghaes, while I hold this zone and try and capture Jinan. So, let's get to work. So the first thing I want to do is get one or two Lafayettes as coastal batteries. These things can do so much damage against these vehicles that they'll be forced to either retreat or turn around. Sorry, or get destroyed. Let's get an FOB in here. I want to make this my defensive position because it's much easier to defend this area than up here. Over here they can just turn around this corner and then pour on fire while I have no time to shoot back at them. Over here I have a bit more time. I can use my FOB with these ATGM carriers as a bit of a standoff defense. It's not much, but it's going to have to do. And let's see which has the longest AA range or ATGM range. Doesn't really matter. These are more accurate with less AP power. And these have less or more AP power with less accuracy. I'm going with these because they carry 12 of these rocket launchers. Those as frontal defense. Now I'm hoping I'm going to be able to get one of these guys in here in time. Won't be easy, but I can use the Panther and get him out of here as soon as possible. Airlift him into Jinan. I can also call in some vehicles, and I should remember to get a command infantry in here as well. Now the problem with this zone is that I cannot bring in anything else. I can bring in air from this side, so I will have to keep a Lafayette back here. And I don't have enough points for that. Okay. That means that I have to be a bit careful. Wait a little bit to get some points. I have an income of 5 plus whatever cohesion I have left. So I can use that. You know what, let's just go. Offload all of these units. Get this command infantry and these Panthers. Hold these Panthers back a little bit. By offloading your command infantry and putting them in Panthers, I'm much faster able to relocate them to Jinan, which makes it a lot easier to capture that area. The alternative is going in there with a VAB, but that's going to take ages. So let's go to Jinan and make it quick. I have a Lafayette coming in, so I can push this Lafayette up to the coast. That will lose me Naval Sector Bravo until this thing comes up, but so be it. Over here we have the first of their units coming in. Oh god. That's not good. What is that? UAZ. We need to hunt that thing down and kill it. These things have poor optics, but I hope they can capture this UAZ before it captures the zone. Pretty accurate fire, and they took it down. Good job there. Now get the hell out before you get shot down by that PGZ-88. Luckily, the Halo with the command infantry survived. She's just in time. Get this Lafayette in here. Now I don't have any AA in here, but my Crotal launcher from the Lafayette should be able to take care of that. There you go. Just a little bit closer. Scutal's firing, took out one helicopter, and the other one. Now they have a range of 4.7 kilometers, and I can bring them in a bit closer here and support this coast very, very well. Command infantry has landed on this sector, so I can bring in some Remus here and hold them off on this zone. As you can see, my supply chain is once again in operation. FOB offloads into the VLRA, and they offload into the Command Marines and these ATGM launchers. Should have brought one more of these, but so be it, it's going to have to do. Once those things arrive, I want them to offload. I'm taking mortar fire. Ooh, these guys are a lot closer than I'd expected. Okay. Bring in some of these vehicles. Offload. Get out. Command infantry is at risk here. Relocate them a little bit. Now I cannot call in air, at least not safely, because there's a PGZ-88 in here. So instead, I'll have to call in some of these Mephistos and deal with that. These are trying to take out my vehicles. These things are engaging, but they have absolutely zero armor. Put these on attack move as well. Seems like they've decided not to attack Charlie anymore, but they have captured Echo. Took down another one. Mephisto is firing his long-range backup. Missed, unfortunately. He's out. Now, I doubt I've gotten all of the infantry which was in there. Oh, hello. These are pretty valuable. 35 points. And they make my defense especially difficult, or my offense, depending on how you want to see this game. Because they can take down all of my bombers. As I had expected, there is quite a bit of infantry here. Let's see, what kind of vehicles do I have which are especially good against infantry? Yeah, I think these VABs. And I still have a couple of those floating out here. Let's bring them in. Lafayette is still supporting the coasts. 240 rounds, so he won't run out of ammo anytime soon. And by holding this naval sector Bravo here, I do have some additional income. They have abandoned Echo, or at least their units on the move. That's interesting. Why would they do that? I'm not threatening them anywhere. Okay, let's push up. See if we can get their command vehicle in Echo, and maybe even push into Delta. Hang on, these things are empty. Pick up your guys. More infantry coming in. Do not lead with your recon. She'll regret that. Get some of these more ERCs in here. These semi-tanks, for lack of a better term. They're running out of ammo. That's quick. Okay, seems like we... Oh, really? They put a command vehicle in here. Nice attack from the back there. I'm gonna compliment them on that. So they pushed all the way through this forest, or over this hill. Another push here. Lafayette's taking artillery fire. Relocate him a little. Only need to get 800 more points. Now they're just giving points away here by sending all of this infantry walking in. Well, these commando marines are taking out vehicles which are getting too close. And they're doing a hell of a job at it. 300 points left to get. Lafayette obliterated some more infantry. Push up. 270 points left. Look at that! Look at that, that's nice. There you go, another 100 points. Leaves me with 174 points left to score. Now I'm gonna wait for these guys. There's another unit coming in. Andouis. Now keep in mind, if I win this, then that means that entire battle group's destroyed because they have nowhere to fall back to. Gotcha. Total victory, regiments destroyed, squadron destroyed, and I killed 2555 points of units. I lost 105, which were one Panther, a VAB, one of those ERC-90s, and a Mephisto. Perfect. Now, Major, I'm happy to announce that we have gained control of the Chinese base of Qingdao. We no longer fear any threat from there. Beijing is protesting to the UN. Yeah, right. But we've demonstrated we can strike China directly if need be. Good. Now that means that I can pack up these guys later and then do another naval evasion right here into Songchon. In the meanwhile, let's have a look at Thaichon. What do they have here? They have 86 tanks and no air support. I see a couple of possibilities here. They have Alpha, so as long as I can keep them contained, making sure that they do not capture Kaesong, Tenchon, Jeonchon, or Pyongyang, then they can call in any more units. They do start with 1300 units. These are pretty expensive tanks. So for 1300 points you can get about 10 of these, say 15 at most, and a couple of command tanks. These are very expensive, by the way. Now before we go in there, let's see if we can get some support. I have this group of Tiger HADs, which are going to be very, very useful against all of those tanks. If you didn't want me to kill you, you should have brought AA with you, but you didn't. Let's also bring in the other helicopter group, because they have scout helicopters. These Gazelle 341F cannons. Or cannons, I'm not sure how you... I think it's French, so it should be more of canon. Anyway, I can also bring in some more forces, hopefully directly into Pyongyang. Anti-air convoy. Ah, the Anzac Air Force. RAAF Strike Squadron. Four F-111Cs. Let's bring those in as well. Do a nice bombing run on these things. Thaichon, here we go. They cannot bring in these multi-rolls because they don't have any air reinforcement, so I really gotta make sure I capture or destroy any of those command tanks. I'm gonna push in from multiple sides, have some infantry in these buildings here to defend that area, some here to defend this area. Foxtrot doesn't really need defending, although it is nice to get the income. So let's first deploy some command units before I forget that. Pyongyang. Yeah, it's nice, but it doesn't really give me any points. Foxtrot does. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a lot of cover. I'm going to use this helicopter to go from Pyongyang to Jeonchon because it gives me reinforcement zone and income. Let's put a command vehicle here in Bravo. Actually, closer to this ridge is better. If I'm fast enough, I can get infantry into these buildings. And in this case, let's see, SEALs have very good anti-tank weaponry. They carry 8 of them. Remas have only 6 with more AP power. Yeah, in this case, I'm going with SEALs. Two groups here as a stopping force. Let's see, this is not a building. There are some buildings here. I want to use these guys as lookouts more than defensive forces, really. One there. Two of them here. And the rest we're going to dump into helicopters. Particularly these HADs, because they have very good autocannons, very good anti-tank weapons, good accuracy, and rocket pods which can even destroy a tank. So let's make a couple of hunter groups, and the main targets are not going to be their tanks, but their command tanks. So two of them there. Actually, it's going to have to be one. Whoops, that's the SEALs done. The alternative is using tow helicopters, or these, for 90 points. These will do. They're a bit cheaper than the expensive Tiger helicopters. So that's the tow version. And I want to get a recon chopper, or several. Let's come in with a third group from here. And I have 140 points, so let's bring in one Tiger. There you go. Get these guys over to this sector. Fly these SEAL, or unload these SEALs. Get these guys up. Disable the tow, so I want to aim those manually. Get the SEALs in here. Get the scouting force in here. Again, disable the tows. Found the first command tank. Offload these SEALs. Where are you going? You're just holding. Unlike these guys. I'm gonna get a shot in on this command tank. There's another one. Get the command tank priority. Lost sight on him. Back here. Took out the command tank. Very good work there. There's another one escaping this side. This seems to be just a regular attack. Got the second command tank and the third one. There you go. Total victory. Took out 3 command tanks out of their 6, so they will be back. But for now, Taichung is safe. Now I have all of these forces here, and it's time to use them against this group. This is a lot of tanks, 36 in this group, 56 in this group. Let's see what kind of map it is. Very open. So decent for anti-tank warfare using planes, so long as they don't have too much anti-air. We have a couple of Pongays, and not much in these groups. They do have Q511s or Q51s. These cannot attack air. So if I can use my Harrier group again, refit these guys. These have the ATGM Harriers, and I also have my Super Hornet attack group. Let's see where here they are. Sent them into this sector. Now from here on I can only go left or right, so I'm going this way. Still got a couple of K1s left. Let's refit these first. Brings me 12 tanks. Actually, refit all of these guys first. I have plenty of points and plenty of time. There you go. Refit the airborne infantry regiment, sorry, battalion. What do we have here? These guys just finished a battle, so I'm all out of points here. These cannot move any further. This is a nice group, by the way. 8 Leclercs. And I've been promised a Leopard battalion as well. This is a group of M1A1s, so disembark these guys as well. I could attack with them, but it's not a lot of units versus that many forces, so I'm going to wait. So let's end the turn. We've captured 2 out of 3 objectives before, it's even in turn 11. I got plenty of time left to go after these guys, but I have been warned that the Russians have decided to show up. Okay, that's a lot of battle scheduled. Pyongyang first. We're up against a tank regiment. Now, my dragoons have taken a pounding, and I only got 9 Brennuses left versus 30 of their tanks, but they're cheap ones. So I can once again use my Habjungs, which I've been heavily depending on, to take out as many tanks as possible. They got 4 command tanks, so I have to go after these guys. They got an anti-air company consisting of Pongays and Shilkas. Well, I don't have any air units anyway. So let's set up defense. Yankee, X-ray, Whiskey, Thaechon. Defend this region, push in from the side and get their command vehicle. Same thing as we did before. I want to once again relocate my FOB. I'm going to have it in here, close to the front line, where I can resupply my majority of my Habjungs. Unfortunately, I lost the recoilless rifles. But so be it. I'm just going to have to defend with whatever I have left. Actually, I'm going with groups of 1. There, now get some command infantry in here. Want all of these zones to get maximum income. And of course some command infantry here. Now I need to bring in some more tanks, and I only got these guys at elite, so they really did a lot of battle lately. Push in some more Habjungs on this side, through here. Get a couple of tanks as backup, and hopefully I have just about enough. Yep. And that completes my points. Offload. All of these vehicles out of the way. Push in with these guys. Offload. 12 points per second income. So far these tanks aren't doing much. Now they're starting to move up. I need to patch this hole here. Now, two Brennesses are not going to stand long against a force that big. Here is a command tank on the move. Let's see if we can get that thing. They're completely bypassing my lines so far. Okay, let's get some tanks in. With their own recon, of course. I really should have patched this thing a lot better than I did. Now the battle's on. Cease fire, you're giving away your position. Push. Push hard. Let's get these guys up. These cannot do anything here, so let's move them to the side. Got a command infantry versus a command tank. That is not a good deal. Get them out of here. I lost a Brennus. No, they got a load of tanks in here. These are just going to have to take up this position in here. They've captured Juliet, which is of no real strategic value. Took out some tanks here. They got another command tank up here on the side. Get these guys back just a little bit. Push in. So far I've taken out quite a bit of tanks, but now they're starting to bypass these lines as well. So let's push up here with some infantry. This tank's taking a lot of damage. Get him out of here. Command tank behind me. He'll probably destroy my Brennus. No, my Brennus got him. Good job there. Get him out of here. Bring in a group of four tanks to push on these guys. Only gotta go through 700 more points. Seems like they've taken out some more Hebjungs here. Relocate this command infantry a little because it is at risk here. They're still bringing in more tanks, and I would really like to have my Leclercs up here. Try and get shots on these bunkers. Got one of them. These Hebjungs are caught between a rock and a hard place. But they took out both Hebjungs, which is excellent. Excellent job there. I'm gonna move up with these guys and take out this tank which is in here, which is a command tank. Well, I have to evacuate this command infantry, or at least relocate it. And I can use these Hebjungs as well. Really, guys? Whatever. Attack move. Recon. Yankee secured. Offload and start clearing here. Let's give these guys a surprise. Make no mistake, these things are very dangerous with their Bastion missiles. 90% of points done. They're almost right on top of my command infantry. Took out another tank here. Let's try and get some AA. That's another one down. Gotcha. No, I didn't play that well this round, I gotta admit that. Anyway, total victory anyway. Kills 1800 points, losses 245. Mostly LVTPs, which means that I got a lot less of these Hebjungs next turn. I only got 14 left. Still, I sent them packing. I destroyed 55 of their tanks. Really? That many? Yeah, it was a full group. Oh well. So once again, Pyongyang defended. They have another incursion into Taichung and one into Taichung. Now this is going to be good. They're pushing into Taichung, where I have all of these heavy tanks. I got these K1s. I got M1A1 Abrams. I'm going to have some fun with these guys. They're coming in from this sector here in the north with 56 tanks. My tanks are a bit better than theirs. M60 ERAs, K1s, M1A1 HC Abrams. Versus their ZTZ85-2s and their ZTZ-59-2As. They do have aircraft. And I have a lot of air support or anti-air units. I can call in a Oliver Hazard Perry to help with them as well. I can use these on the coast and batter these ships. Get 6 of these STRBH-90s or 90Hs on the coast and suppress those tanks as they drive by. I do not have any air support this round, no helicopters, but my tanks are just going to slug it out. So first, capture all of these zones, put command infantry into anything, especially this one, that's worth a lot of points. Charlie's worth some points, Alpha's worth some points, so let's put a Mitsubishi in here, and one way back here. Now I'm going to stall for time using an Oliver Hazard Perry, which cannot go in this far. Wow, they have to stay out real far. That's too far for me. Keep this LAV back here. Use these STRB-90s. These can reach near the coast. I have 3 LCUs and I got Pegasus. Pegasus can be used against vehicles. So let's get 2 of these in. No, actually they're not necessary here. Instead, let's get some defense up here. I have Kutais, I have a couple of Chumats because these have been rearmed. Do they have a good line of fire from here? Yeah, decent. Not great. This is probably a better position to defend from. I have an FOB which I can call in. And then some Chumats. Here. Might as well make it 2x2 because they do have those aerials which can make my day a bit worse. Like that. Recon. Spot for those. Now I also need to have some AA because I know that they can come in with those aircraft. These have the best range against aircraft, 26-25. Keep them near my base. Yeah, that should do. Offload. Offload these guys. 16 points income per second. Let's see where I how far I can place this Oliver Hazard Perry in, because it does have great anti-air missiles. Too expensive for now. Here we go. Yeah, they can really not reach up here. It's too close to the coasts. These guys are still out of range. Let's get them a bit closer to the coast while we start to prep our defense using tanks as well. These K1s should do the job pretty well. 9 rounds per minute. 9 rounds. This is overkill. K1's good enough. Let's thin these guys out a little bit. And of course they're all going after the same target, which is a waste of missiles. They are running out of Hellfires, which is perfectly fine. I'll have some LCUs here waiting for them. Took out another 15-point unit, okay. It's a little less than I'd expected. Out of ammo. One Hellfire left. Get a little closer. Two Hellfires left. And one. This guy took out... Nope, didn't take him out. Get out of here. This guy here took out another vehicle. He's out of Hellfires. And there seems to be another push here. Now just with these ships, I already took out about 1,000 points. So they have really done their job well. There you go. Now you get out of here. And we get some more missiles in these things. I hope this thing makes it out alive. Look at the speed of these units. Nice. Okay. What do we have here? This is a recon, I suppose. And I have neglected to defend this sector because I forgot about this bridge. So, let's chopper in some units if we can do that. No, we cannot. Okay. In that case, they're going to have to cross all the way here with their tanks, so I'm going to defend here with some Chumats. And some tanks, some K1s should do. Have a closed arrow AA unit in, and a 263 to stun their aircraft, and of course a recon. There you go. Now, let's start to bring in more K1s. Build up my own force. And then we're going to push in. Just look at how fast I'm getting this income. Now, these K1s have already fought a large number of battles, and I only had about 4 survivors. But those 4 survivors are all elite tanks. So it seems these are all packing some new ammo. This one's done. This one's almost done. Yep, there you go. Why are these guys going towards the shore? There's nothing out there here for them to capture. Or kill. Other than these STRB-90s. But good luck killing that. Missed. Kill. Exchanging fire. Got a command unit here. Let's hunt that thing down. K1 destroyed? Really? That's a bad airstrike. Now, let's have some fun. Call in some of these heavy Abrams. These are already running out of ammo again. I've killed so many units. There you go, out of ammo. Get the LCUs a bit closer to the shore. These things are just pounding my tanks, which is not good. So the message they're sending me is get more AA, which I will do. Here's my two Abrams tanks. Get some side shots on these things, although they can probably engage them and destroy them with their 22 AP power right from the front. 12 AP, AP defense. Two mats are also engaging. Took out one tank. Firing. Down. Another kill shot. Aircraft coming in. For fuck's sake, shoot these things down now, can you? Jesus. Damn near destroyed those Abrams. Out of Hellfires. Reloading with these things. These still got some left. I'm going to call in some Stingers here and put those in the hills. Worked really, really well with those Mistrals last time. Just easy pickings here. Very easy. That's another one down. This one's back up. Calling another LCU, I have plenty of points. This group of K1s is ready to go. Where are you going? So, it's time to do a counter push. Something that has good off-road speed, such as an LAV-25. Start to push up with these K1s. Bring in some more of these super heavies. Okay. I mean, at this stage, I can just do as I please. I have so much income. I can call in some very, very fun and very heavy units, and they can barely do anything against me, except airstrike them maybe. 80 points of destruction, 80% of destruction points. This one's ready to go. Keep in mind, these things are river craft, so they can go all the way up this river and right up to the shore where they have a good range on those tanks. 92% accuracy. Very nice. Abrams are good to go. My other Abrams are good to go. LAV, push up. Though I think that these things are so effective that I won't have any time to go after a command tank here. Good shot, killed that thing. Speed this up a bit. Keeping these closed arrows together on the shoulder of the mountain. Oh, look at that. So that I can engage any aircraft that flies over to do an airstrike on these units. Gotta make sure this scout doesn't get killed. Terrain is blocking line of sight and they're still out of range. Not a problem for these Hellfires though. There's their air, which did not do an airstrike. Put these on attack move. Just 140 points left. Easy enough. Aircraft coming in, out of range. They lost visual on the target, probably. Get this LAV 25 to move up, 35 points left. They are trying to do bombing runs on these guys, on those tanks down below, but they don't have a visual, so they cannot call in those units. 22nd Tank Regiment has been destroyed, took out 40 tanks, 3 command tanks, and they just got completely obliterated. Look at the kill list these STRB-90s racked up. Very nice. And I believe I did lose one K1, but for some reason it's not listed. See? It should be down here. Losses. K1. Oh well, I'll take it. And with that, I'm going to stop the recording of this video. This was it for part 17. Or is it 18 already? I lose track. There's so many parts in this thing. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please hit like. If you want to see more of my videos, subscribe to my channel. And if you have a suggestion, question, or idea, let me know in the comments. I look forward to reading your ideas. Thanks for watching. See you next part.